judge, by my command, in the event of a knockdown, the fighter standing will go to the furthest neutral corner and stay there. Protect yourself at all times. Touch gloves.
That's a little bit high.
The vacant world bantamweight crown on the line. A prize that unbeaten Puerto Rican Emmanuel Rodriguez can capture. But unfortunately, elsewhere, Paul Butler is unable to because he failed to make the 8'6" or 118-pound set. A little like the situation Scott Quick found himself in recently against Oscar Valdez. Still a serious night for Butler. And there must be a huge weight advantage. Will that prove useful to the man from Cheshire in the red trunks? Big Liverpool fan. Yeah, the predominantly blue of Emmanuel Rodriguez. In his 18th outing, 4 years younger, comes with a huge reputation. It was always going to be a difficult task and step up again for Butler, even though he's been a world champion before.
Yes, it's always going to be a tough ask, and the weight that you just talked about, I mean, that's, if anything, a big positive. It's always a comfort for a fighter to be able to do the weight quite easily, and obviously he didn't make the weight, so how hard did he try? I'm not sure there's much of a beneficial game plan in that, because he can't win the IBF title.
The word is, he wasn't feeling great around the time Liam Smith got ill and pulled out of his fight. His world title tilt, but Butler's obviously fit and strong enough to go through with it. And what about Rodriguez? What about the mindset there? They've been very buoyant all week, the big Puerto Rican team around him, trying to follow in the footsteps of the great fighters that Puerto Rico have produced over the years. Good body shot from Butler.
Very good body shot. Nice right hand place just below the left elbow, Rodriguez. And he felt that one.
Oh, the left elbow from Rodriguez. That's the reply. And he's badly hurt Butler in the first round. The count's at 7. He just about gets to his feet. And there's the power of Emmanuel Rodriguez. And there's a minute left in the first. How are the legs gone?
Well, it was a sharp, almost effortless looking left hook from Rodriguez. And the legs look solid, but it's round one, but this is really bad.
Oh, that side just to the head. And Butler's in a whole heap of trouble here. Can he make it through the opening session? He says he's okay to referee Bob Williams in his first ever world title fight, the referee. And it might not last long.
And we wasn't sure about Rodriguez, but we're finding out pretty sharp. They call Butler quality opposition. Coming up stop here, terrible in the first round.
And a good uppercut there from Rodriguez. Punching with the tape sections and accurate too. The timing, he can't miss Butler.
Well, Butler needs to move. He's moving the right direction, but he needs to keep going and just keep out of his way and try and see this round out. That's 10 seconds here.
Body shot, he digs in his own hook back, but has he got the firepower to compete with this Puerto Rican? He's had a wonderful start.
Also from Hellsford fought the great Marco Antonio Barrera in London. And it was a 10-7 round. He was cut in both eyes. They pulled him out after one session. It's not quite as dramatic, but similarities.
Yes, I mean, look at the quality work there, Rodriguez. Just basic boxing, really. He placed the left hook so effortlessly, and when it landed, it just, the effect was there to see. I mean, I don't know how Paul Butler now comes back from this, because he looks so badly hurt. Only in round one, so it's a really great group.
Round two.
Second round, vacant IBF bantamweight title on the line. Paul Butler in real trouble here. Can he get any sort of foothold into the fight? Emmanuel Rodriguez with sharpness and speed and power, and that right hook bouncing off Butler's chin, but he can't keep taking shots like that. He looks really good, this Puerto Rican.
He does. He's landing lead right hands. Very sharp. He
somebody so effortlessly just picking their shots. 171 of 182 amateur fights, unbeaten as a pro. No wonder there's excitement about him.
Well, there's a lot of big noise for Rodriguez. They're talking about him like he's the next big thing.
Just shakes his head, Rodriguez, and says that in troublemaker. That jab piercing through the defensive partner. And a lovely right hand as well. Timing so good, so early, Carl.
Yeah, just really relaxing and just easing into it, but it had such an effect. With inaccurate punches, he'll be very confident. The IBF title's on the line here. I mean, it's up for grabs for Rodriguez. So he's taking this very seriously. He won't really worry too much about Paul Butler's weight. Just getting on with it, and you can see how serious it is. I mean, he's not getting excited. He's not trying to cut the show. He realises this is still only round two. But what a great start for him.
But a former world champion who's a quality operator. He's only lost once in 27 fights. That was by stoppage to the excellent Zalani Tete. But it was much later on. Rodriguez has been firing at him from the opening bell. But they did well to survive the opening, didn't they?
He did very well. I mean, he seems to have recovered. Maybe it's a bit of a flash knock now.
He's regrouped. Listen to his corner. He's still getting caught with a flashy shot. Standing still in front of Rodriguez. He needs to be moving his head more. His feet getting off the side. He's giving him angles. And throwing things. But Rodriguez, very accurate, very sharp. We saw that movement when he outboxed and outclassed Stewie Hall in Liverpool. This is a case of levels, this one. Long way to go, of course. On the bobbing and weaving. Popular fighter on the scene. Comfortable in there, isn't he, behind that jab? Rodriguez, looking for quick fire
right hand. Even if Butler's protecting himself with some of them, the force of them as well on the gloves, and if he is giving a fair amount of weight away, Rodriguez, he obviously possesses some dynamite in those fists.
I mean, he's doing the right thing, trying to back up Rodriguez, keeping this something to think about, but you can see here, he's just being picked up. It's not the centre of the ring, Paul Butler, but he's getting picked up in the centre of the ring, which is bad news. It just shows the speed and the class, you know, the quality of punches for Rodriguez, and the accuracy is there.
A lot of blood from the nose of Paul Butler. I wonder if that's gone. And that could really be problematic as the rounds tick on. But there was a right hand from Rodriguez at the end of that one. Difficult for Butler this. 25 at Wembley. Joshua, of course, beating Charles Martin in this very arena to really kickstart his career. We wait and see what happens next with the AJ Wilder situation. We'll be hearing from Anthony a little bit later on. Here's the fourth IBF bantamweight crown on the line. Remember, Emmanuel Rodriguez, the only one that can take this home because of the problems and the weigh-in from Paul Butler. He was 3 pounds, 5 ounces over, and he's been on the canvas a couple of times tonight. The problems are continuing.
There certainly are in front of a man in Rodriguez who seems to be in second gear. He's still having it all his own way. Taking nothing away from Paul Butler, but the quality of Rodriguez, the effort does work, and the quality of his shots, the accuracy and the speed. It's just such a difficult task for Paul Butler. It's hard to try and explain to people how he gets back into this one, but Paul did some heavy things here, just short little left hooks. Everything Rodriguez does, when he decides to step it up, it has an effect. It's almost the waiting game for him. He's really enjoying himself today, Rodriguez.
Latino bantamweight title coming off a victory over Giovanni Delgado as he goes to work on Butler again, and that nose looks a bloody mess for Paul Butler. It's just non-stop, isn't it, from Rodriguez, and I think the accuracy and the punch picking, the selection has been so impressive.
It's definitely very impressive, and I almost feel that mentally now he's switched it up a level and he's starting to enjoy himself and maybe thinks to himself, you know what, this might be the time to show that again. Almost like he's going to decide when he wants to finish it. Almost he can. I don't like the arrogance, but don't get me wrong, there's a lot of class in Rodriguez.
14 stoppages on the Butler slate. Can he in any way deter Rodriguez? Right hand from the Puerto Rican, just off balance there. Butler straight back into the fold. Straight back into more menacing punches from Rodriguez.
Well, that was the speed there of Rodriguez, evident for everybody to see. I mean, Paul Butler threw quite a sharp jab, and the right hand landed before his jab even got anywhere near Rodriguez. That was timing and speed.
You mentioned the arrogance or the swagger of Rodriguez, but his face has been etched in concentration, hasn't he? He's going about this intelligently. Good blocking of body shots there from Rodriguez.
Yes, very, very professional. I mean, you can see he's concentrating, thinking about what he's doing. He's not taking anything for granted.
That right hand again, over the top. Plenty of guts here shown from Butler, standing in front of him, bobbing and weaving upper half of the body, but not getting anything in these rounds.
Followed by the left hook. Uppercut passed up there from Rodriguez. Knocking Paul Butler there back off balance. Good advice from Joe Gallagher in the corner. Throw the fakes. A lot of advice actually, because, you know, trying to cover all angles, giving him plenty of advice, plenty to think about. Sometimes you can over inundate your mind with too much information. Maybe keep it simple. But this is good. He's having a go. He's trying to take Rodriguez and try and get him into later rounds and hope that the weight, by making the weight, fades him. But it's a risky gamble to take with sharp counts coming straight back at him.
He came out with a bit very fast, Paul Butler. Quite combinations to the body, but Rodriguez again controlling the centre of the ring. Clever with his distance. Butler trying to find gaps, but there are many.
This is gutsy stuff from Paul Butler. He's getting picked up here, almost hit him well, but he's still but he's still going forward, trying to look for it to create openings. Fortunate for him, but the sharpness and the accuracy of Rodriguez is too much.
I like Rodriguez's attitude, not only in the ring, but outside of the ring all week. There's been a real confidence about him, and he had no problem continuing with this fight despite the weight advantage that Butler has. Butler has a great deal of support in here tonight. Is that going to be enough? He's not won anything, has he, Cole?
Unfortunately, no, he's not. Rodriguez, as you say, he's come into this fight very confident. He's got a bit of a swagger about him outside the ring on the field up for this, and he has every right to do so. We mentioned earlier the world junior silver medalist as an amateur, 17 fights unbeaten as a professional. He's come here now, this is his world title fight. He's got to take this.
It is a step up as well for Rodriguez. He's looking every bit a world champion in waiting.
Well, we hope to see Paul Butler take him into the later round, so we can see if he can put some kind of pressure on Rodriguez as he slows. He will slow down, he's human. As the round drag on, he will start to set his feet a little bit, he'll stay there a bit longer, and that's when Paul Butler can maybe start to have some success.
He's got plenty of 12 round experience as well, Paul Butler. Very seasoned, and he looked like he could do another three or four when he fought Stewie Hall the other week. He was a few months ago, when he was really in a rhythm, and he was concentrating, and he was picking holes in Hall, who's always tough and strong and brave. It is about levels, this one.
It is, yeah, that rhythm you talked about against Hall. He can't get any rhythm with Rodriguez because he's just getting picked up.
Yeah, good jab. Solid all-round ability from Emmanuel Rodriguez. In southeast London, the O2 Arena, waiting for the big match, of course, later on. But we're all enjoying watching the class and the movement of Emmanuel Rodriguez from Playa Maya in Puerto Rico. In with Ellsworth Falls' Paul Butler. We know how good Butler's been over the years, but he just can't get a foothold in this. Brave, stubborn, getting the occasional combination and trying ever so hard, Butler, as he always does, but just can't get anything major off. Certainly not to offset Rodriguez and snap him out of this.
No, that's right, Adam. Difficult task in front of him. In Rodriguez, and this head movement and this slip and sliding and trying to back up Rodriguez in the face, this one needs to, because this will get the energy out of Rodriguez. It's always dangerous because obviously he's going to put himself in the danger zone, in range for a counterpunch, sharp counterpunch, the accurate hooks and uppercuts that are coming back for Rodriguez, but it's the only chance Butler had to try and push it back.
Doubling up the jab on Butler's nose, that's sensible from Rodriguez. Nick Williamson's done a great job in the corner, but now he's just planting his feet a tad more, Rodriguez. These jabs look sickening, Carl.
Yeah, that's because they're so sharp and accurate. They landed on the face of Paul Butler, almost as well as he comes forward. Still trying though, Paul Butler. He's not giving up, you can see that. He's got a steely look about him. He's planting his feet in front of Rodriguez, just trying to back him up. And he's so aware of the quality that's coming back at him. Just constantly being kept on edge.
Baby faced assassin. Wondering Marco Antonio Barrera, who he obviously idolised, as many people in boxing did. One of the great fighters of the modern generation. So many too from Puerto Rico, the likes of Felix Trinidad and Miguel Cotto, following a long line of greats like Alfredo Gomez, Wilfred Benitez, Carlos Ortiz, Hector Camacho. What a colourful character. Multi-weight division champion he was. It's just a Caribbean jewel, isn't it, that produces wonderful fighters.
It certainly is. Good left up there from Rodriguez. Some of the names you chucked into the mix there, Adam. Eric Morales, my favourite. Pereira, obviously, right up there with him. But this weight division really does produce some quality.
Right,
dripping from the nose of Butler. Still trying to dig his own feet in, but he's really finding nowhere to go in there. Still bringing up the big right hand, and I think that hurt Butler here. Last 10 seconds of the sink. Getting to the sort of point where he came apart against Alani Tete. And Rodriguez is starting to get some more meat into these punches.
Myself was fine. Joshua watched a lot of that.
I think he really just enjoyed the fight and the whole spectacle last night. More of the same. I'm sure there will be twists and turns and drama ahead.
Well, in the second half now, this Rodriguez showcase, which is what it's looking like. He starts to battle for Butler at the end of round six.
Just squeezing a body shot there for Butler. That's an honor of respect for him. Still determined here, Butler. But the right hand, he just can't get out of the way with the speed of it.
But he has to try something. Joe Gallagher will be saying to him, now you've got to go to it, you've got to start trying to make some kind of impact on Rodriguez. He can't sit back because it's just, you know, the writing's on the wall.
Losing round after round, he's got to take a gamble, a risk, but then he's going to leave himself open, isn't he? That's the problem. Has he got the own power to really hurt Rodriguez? You've got to wonder about the camp as well, beforehand, why he was so heavy on the scales.
That's right, I mean, his punch ratio, he's probably got a 50% knockout rate, so he can bag, but these bantamweights don't tend to have that one punch knockout.
Nice shot there, but Rodriguez back with his own crisp 1-2, doubling that up. To hunt down Butler, trap him on the ropes. This is where he wants him.
Well, he's having a go here, Butler, but as he does, Rodriguez just answers and backs him up. So sickening for Paul Butler.
Right hand again from Rodriguez. Remember, Butler on the floor twice in the opening round. Done ever so well to grip this out, but it is becoming a real painful night for Butler.
Showing no emotion, Rodriguez just concentrating, almost a poker face in there, nothing to read for Paul Butler, just got to keep trying to plug away, but it's almost, and I don't like to say it, but it's almost mission impossible in there for Paul Butler, because Rodriguez really is that good.
Continues behind the jab, stalking Butler, all blood from the face, but you can't dare about his spirit and will. He's digging in here, he's digging very deep. He could have sat this one out at some stage, couldn't he, in between rounds, but he wants it so bad. Rodriguez as well, and Butler still believes here.
The bravery is admirable by Paul Butler, he really is going for it. He's not backing up, he's staking range, but he has to try and get
the cogs. It's a really, really good fight that coming up. Super middleweight match. But he's a really good fighter in Emmanuel Rodriguez. Paul Butler is too. He just hasn't been able to live with Rodriguez so far. I don't think the three judges could have given him anything really. As I said, the heart and guts have been with Butler, but the class and quality with Emmanuel Rodriguez. What will the corner be thinking? Joe Gallagher and the team are experienced in there. Will they have any hope that he can pull this off later on, or will they be thinking about their fighter?
Well, they'll be thinking about preservation, but at this level, he's got to stay in there. I mean, he's not been under any serious pressure where he looks like he's getting hurt. He's certainly still full of spirit, as we can see. He's showing a lot of bravery, but he's losing every round, so he's difficult.
The side quandary as well is that Butler can't win the world title. So, he's probably going to go home bruised and in a bit of pain. He'll want to see the 12 rounds out. And time is ticking if he's going to make any sort of impression on Rodriguez. Just having the pace himself here, isn't he?
to take Rodriguez's legs and try and, you know, preserve the damage he gets inflicted to. I mean, you can see his face is looking bruised and swollen and bloodied from the shots of Rodriguez. If you can back Rodriguez up and put him under pressure, continue this pressure on, then if Rodriguez is going to fall apart, which obviously fall apart is a strong word, but start to fade and slow down, that's when Butler can have a chance.
No signs yet, but no dramatic finish. Well, we thought that might be after the first round. I wonder if he's pacing himself a little as well, Rodriguez, because of the weight difference in there. Just to make sure he gets it absolutely right. He's a pleasure to watch though, isn't he, Carl?
He is a pleasure to watch. He looked like he could maybe force a stoppage on Paul Butler earlier, and I thought he was going to try and step into it. You know, he was almost nonchalant in his body language, and he was showing a bit of arrogance in there, working, dropping his gloves, sticking his chin out of it, landing shots at well. But he's calmed down now, and he's settling down, and maybe he's going to settle for a point win here.
Next part that missed there. This long spearing jab, so at least it is beforehand, and the reach is pretty close as Butler tries to engage with him up close.
Landed a nice jab there, Butler. One of very few, but he got through. Back to Rodriguez.
Yeah, like myself, believe he got a lot of criticism for Obama yesterday after not making the weight, not attempting to drag himself down afterwards, but he's keeping his pride intact here, very much so. Being outclassed, outboxed, and losing on the scorecards round after round, but still he tried, still he stands in front of Emmanuel Rodriguez. Tough that, isn't it, for a trainer, Carl?
Yeah, it must be very tough. I mean, he's got to send his man out, Paul Butler, and it's difficult to know what to tell him. He's got to keep the head movement, he's got to try and get the jab established. The speed and accuracy and the counter punch of Rodriguez. Picking that sharp jab. Rodriguez looking for the counter right now. So, not really any urgency in his work. Doesn't really look like he wants to step it up or try and go for any kind of stoppages. Maybe he'll try that later on, but at the minute he's not flat-footed, but he's not really on his toes as much as backing up Butler.
Butler's been 12 rounds on 4 occasions, Rodriguez never passed the 10th. As he goes to work here, head and body with combinations, and just puts a slight injection of pace in midway through the 9th.
On the receiving end, there's some nice quality work, body and head combination from Rodriguez. And Paul Butler turned off the ropes and answered back. Very brave, still looking for that right hand.
Victor Ortiz, Freddy Trinidad, Pedro Cruz alongside us in the red corner of Emmanuel Rodriguez. Look very happy. Just little bits of advice. They've got a good fighter. Can he close the show, Rodriguez?
Well, the question mark and the talk before this was, what has Rodriguez done? Who's he beat? We're not sure about it. He's looked good in all of his fights, but, you know, of his 17 wins, 12 of them have come early, so he can obviously punch a bit, but does he have that finish in him and that punching power at world level? We're not really seeing that here against Paul Butler, but let's not forget, Paul Butler is a quality operator at this level.
The uppercut was a lovely shot from Rodriguez. Hasn't overused that. To box behind the jab, looking for the quick right hand, but now he's light on his feet, enjoying himself in there.
He does look like he can step it up a gear. It looks like he's sort of holding back and just cruising through, which is, you know, I don't want to play down Paul Butler's bravery in parts, but it's all far too easy for Rodriguez to do.
Another uppercut, just showing off his edges at ringside. Carlos Colon from Puerto Rico, Patrick J. Morley from America, and just in front of us, your
6-year-old Fred Howard Foster. Will they be giving absolutely everything from start to finish to Rodriguez?
Yes, I don't see how they can do anything other than score every round to Rodriguez. And you've obviously got that devastating round for Paul Butler. Lost that one 10-7, down twice. Showing such bravery to come back from two knockdowns in the first round to still be here in round 10. Still trying to push Rodriguez back.
Talking about bravery, back in November 2010, Rodriguez was involved in a road accident that saw him suffer second-degree burns to 66% of his body, kept him out of boxing for almost a year. Incredible comeback from life-threatening stuff. You just, so many tales aren't there in this crazy world, and look at him now, boxing, literally guiding himself, cruising towards a world title after suffering something like that.
Amazing, some of the stories. It's all where the grub, where they grow up, it's all part of it. A lot of these punches, you know, it's hard.
Responded as most fighters would desire work. I'm not bothered about the nose, I don't care about the damage to my face.